Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video series, we want to take a look behind the scenes of the Extending SAP Solutions Using Microsoft Power Platform webinar. This is Chapter 7, where we take a closer look at Power Virtal Agents and the integration of bots in Microsoft Teams. So far, we have looked at creating standalone apps using Power Apps. We automated flows using Power Automate, and now we want to create a chatbot which allows users to interact with their SAP systems directly from within Teams. The possibility to create a bot has been around for quite some time, but now with Power Virtal Agents, it's actually very, very easy to create these bots directly from within Teams. This Power Virtal Agents is a functionality that is available either standalone in a dedicated URL in the browser, or you can also run Power Virtal Agents directly from within your Teams application. Then you can quickly create a bot without writing any line of code. Similar like what we've seen with Power Apps and Power Automate, you just drag and drop certain actions and have required input and output parameters. Then we can also leverage the very same connectivity options, like for example our custom connector for SAP, to then interact with the SAP system in a very easy and intuitive way. As promised, we'll start directly from Microsoft Teams. So if there are enough permissions, this is exactly like what any business user can do. And if you click on these three dots, then you can search for Power Virtal Agent and add this specific application to your Teams client. Again, you might have to ask for permissions from your Teams administrator, but if that's all done, then you can easily start Power Virtal Agents from within Teams. So you can start here and create a first chatbot within 5 minutes. And this is literally how much it costs you to get started. So I'll click here on Start Now. I'll select the Teams scenario that I want to integrate. So in my case, this is the Teams Contoso that I want to develop this chatbot for. And I just click on Create to get started. Now I need to give my bot a name so that people can find it afterwards. So I'll just call it Fetch Product Information from SAP. I can also specify the language to get started. So I'll just leave the default English. And now the bot is being created. This can take some time, especially for the very first time when you do it the first time. You just need to wait a little until Power Virtal Agents sets everything up so that the whole framework is in place and you can finally then actually get started with your bot. So once you're there, then you can already test the bot, obviously on the left-hand side, but more importantly, the interaction between the bot here is with so-called topics. So for example, if I type in hello, then there's some greetings that is already available out of the box. And this is done by using these so-called topics. So by default, when you create this first chatbot, Power Virtal Agents has already created this greeting topics for you. And if we take a look at this canvas, then you can see there are certain trigger phrases, good morning, hello, hello agent, and whatever. And only if these trigger phrases are matched, then this hi, I'm a virtual agent, the whole flow gets started. So what we want to do now is we want to create a new topic. This new topic is supposed to fetch data from the SAP system. So we'll just call it fetch from SAP. And now we need to add certain trigger phrases, list product details or fetch products details, or maybe something from SAP, show me product details from SAP. Or maybe it's just SAP or some of these trigger words. Obviously, the more trigger words or sentences you provide, the better the lookup, the match will be in the end. Keep in mind, it doesn't have to be exactly these words after at the end. We'll use some natural language processing to try to match this. After that, we go to this authoring canvas. And so if the trigger phrases are matched, then we can greet our user with a certain message. So we can say, sure, let's look up product information from SAP. So this is just a welcome message that will greet the user once the trigger phrase is matched. Then we'll go to the actual actions that we want to do. So the first thing is we'll ask the user a question. What is the product ID and the result? So we want to use the full entire response. The result of this response will make this available in a variable called user product ID. So this is the user input for the product ID. Once we have the product ID, then we can actually already reach out to the SAP system. So we select call an action. And what we want to do is we actually want to use a Power Automate flow to interact with the SAP system. Since we do not yet have this specific flow, we'll just click on create Power Automate flow. We'll get some templates here. So there's one template, Power Virtual Agents flow template, which we'll just select as a starting point. And from this template, we can pass over the input. So remember now in our flow, we have now this user product ID. So we'll wait for one input field and we'll call this input field product ID. We can just leave it like this. Then once we have this product ID, we can actually make the call to the SAP system. And obviously you're already very familiar with this because we can use the very same custom connector that we used also in Power Automate, that we used in Power Apps to connect to the SAP system. So here I'll select the SAP OData sample connector. I need to provide some connection details. I need to provide my username and password for the SAP system, because in this case we're just using basic authentication. Obviously this could be also a single sign on flow, but yeah, again we'll just stick to basic authentication here. Then, and this is a very well-known field already, we'll just pass over the product ID. We don't care about the CSRF token now because we just want to retrieve information, and then as a result we can actually return information from the SAP system. So what we want to return is the product name. Obviously here now we have the full list of response parameters from our get product screen. So we'll just take the name. We'll also return here the product description. So again, this is one of the return variables that we get when calling our get product. And then finally, we also add the price. So we'll also ask for return the product price. Obviously, this list could be much, much longer and we could return all the parameters that we got from the SAP system. But just to show how it's done, let's just take these three parameters. So the name, the description, the price, and that's it. That's our very, very simple Power Automate flow that uses the very same concept that we also used in Power Apps and Power Automate before. So with this, we can go back to our Power Virtual Agents. And now obviously we ask the question. We now select the call and action. Now we see the Power Automate flow. So this create Power flow template. We should have probably renamed it to something different, but so now we can see that this flow requests or has one input parameter and will just pass over this user product ID. And then as a result, we get three variables, product name, product description, and product price, which we then can use in another message that we post back to the user in the chat. And we'll just say product, the product that you ask for. So the product user product ID, and then we'll say is, now we can use the product name that we got back from the SAP system, which is, so we can use the product description, and then finally we can also return the costs, which is product price. So with this, now we could do some a little more formatting. We could bold some sentences, stuff like that, but now our flow is basically done. We have some trigger phrases, we greet the user, we ask the user a question, we store this variable in user product ID, we'll pass over this variable to our Power Automate flow, and as a result, we get the product name, the description, and the price back, which we then show the end user. So we can just save this flow, and now you'll see a warning. And again, I'm really trying to do this with a trial Power Automate or Power Virtual Agent subscription. So I get a warning that I need to have a premium license in order to do this. Now, the beautiful thing here is that it's actually fairly easy to get a trial for this premium license. So if you click on, if we click on the Learn More button, then you can see that it's fairly easy to actually give it a try. So I'll just click on Learn More, and I can start a 60 days free trial with this premium Power Virtual Agents functionality. With this, everything is done. Now everything is green. Now I can actually really test it. So I'll save this again, and I can give it a quick try. I can just interact here on the left-hand side with my bot. So I can just type in hello. So we'll go through the whole greeting topics that is there. And now if I just say, show me product details from SAP, or it could also be something similar, obviously, that we now trigger this specific canvas or this application canvas, then we are asked for the question about the product ID. So we'll put in HD2000, and now we are connecting to the SAP system via this Power Automate flow. You can see this step was now triggered, and as a result we get the product name, the description, and also the price back from the SAP system. With this, we're actually good to go. So we have tested our flow. Everything looks nice. So the next step that needs to be done is to actually publish this specific bot into Teams. So I'll just click on publish. Again, I could also publish this to other sources, but in my specific case, I just want to publish it into Teams. So I'll click on publish latest content. And then I can actually open basically now as an end user this application or this bot within my Teams environment. So I'll just click on add. And now if I go to the chat view of Teams, I can see here this greeting that we also saw before in the test window. So hello returns the whole greetings. And now I'll just put in show me product details from SAP again. And we are now in our fetch product SAP trigger phrase. So now I'll provide another product ID, and we get the information back from the SAP system.